Facilities, that's for sure. But this place, when it was first built, it was a damn good stadium, you know, as far as pro football was concerned back in, 58, 57. And then, of course, the coach came and he changed everything, you know, as we started to win, more seats were put into this great stadium. And I really believe that this is the best stadium in America. I don't care. I've seen a lot of great stadiums in America. Nothing compares to this stadium here. And the pros are the college. This is really the number one stadium. And you all should be very, very proud of the backing that y'all have given the Packers and given the company here to build a facade like this, because this is really special.
Hey, let me ask you, how, I guess, proud were you when it all goes back to the original title? Two-time MVP, Bart Starr, the Lombardi Trophy, the heritage that was presented at Super Bowl 40 this year.
I thought it was wonderful. And I know Max felt the same way. We saw Bart being introduced. It was absolutely sensational. Although, as much as I love Bart, always kidding, the Super Bowl MVP of Super Bowl I was this guy right here. Considering he was out all night, I don't know how he scored there, but I do know one thing, he was unstoppable the next day.
You know, I had an advantage. Every time I look back to catch a ball, it's two or three of them, I just picked the one I looked the best and played off.
That first catch we see on all the highlights, your first touchdown reception where you had to reach behind you and grab the ball. Were you surprised the ball stuck? He looked like one of those look what I found type things.
Surprised, I was shocked. I could tell the guy closing in on me, and I said, well, he might intercept this ball, so I better knock it down. So I stuck my hand back, and it's stuck in my hand. What am I going to do with this? I tried it over the goal line, and that was the first touchdown in history.
Super. Unbelievable.
Otherwise, I wouldn't have it.
San Francisco's championship teams are very different teams. You know, you guys Jackson. It was the same core of players that won all those five titles.
Exactly. I really thought the Dallas team that won so big in the Super Bowl there, I thought that they could have been the best team in the history of this game.
You mean in the early 90s?
The early 90s, right. Yeah. But what happened was free agency broke up the team.
Yep.
See, we didn't have a chance for that. I mean, we had to stay here. I mean, we were under contract, and we couldn't break the contract.
Paul, you go back to the 70s. Remember the Dolphins teams, those two Super Bowl teams?
Right.
And one of them was undefeated in 72. And the following year, they were the USFL, I believe, was coming online. And Zonka and some of those guys were leaving. So that team in the 70s got broken up a little bit, too. You know, and so, that, I think, was what it was all about. The other thing is, and you guys aren't from here, and you travel the country, but I think there's some kind of appeal about middle-of-the-country teams, small-market teams, when they win, the rest of the country cheers for them. You know, when Green Bay is the smallest market, little Green Bay wins a championship, people get on board with that who really have no interest out in California or
After having won so many in the 60s,
right,
there's a little different feeling because it doesn't matter where I go, and I'm sure Max is the same way. What the hell? We're 70 years old. I'm 70 years old, and I still get invited to dinners, to appearances, and we're still popular. And that's amazing. And I always kid the youngsters, you know. I was kidding Montana. We had a show out in California. He was talking about. He signed 220 autographs, and I signed 210 at this dinner. Of course, he's charging $200 for his autograph, and I was charging like $40. But I kidded him, you know, and he said, well, you know, I'm going to gross a lot more money. I said, try grossing it when you're 70, pal.
Yeah.
Let's see how many places you can go when you're 70.
That's true. That's very true. The other thing that happened in the 60s that you guys had nothing to do with was the NFL entered a golden age. And the golden age was spawned by television. That Giants and Colts playoff game in, what, 58, I want to say? It kind of started it, where you guys really picked it up in the 60s, became the glamour team. I think that was a big part of it as well. Would you agree?
Absolutely. We've got to thank Pete Rozelle for that. Because I think he's been the best commissioner in the history of this league. And I never had any animosity as far as Pete and I were concerned over my suspension from the league. Because he had to make a move. He made the move that he thought was best, and I think it was. And the only thing I regret about it, I've never told Coach Lombardi before I was sentenced, because he felt that I would have talked to him about it. He could have made a difference. He may have made a difference in that situation. I don't know. But as it turned out all right. And Vince went to bat for me very strongly in that my sabbatical year. And I got back in the course of next year. And of course, McGee went to New York and grabbed Rozelle by the throat and said, I need my man back. So
you got back a year later.
I really miss you when you were gone. I used to go to Speed's Lounge running and I'd go. I'd sit in on the bar stool and I'd just back off. All the girls would come around him. I'd come up and have a few drinks and I'd steal one.
That's bullshit. You know?
Well, I thought we were better at the Piccadilly myself. Nobody was old enough to remember.
I see some smiles out there.
Yeah, Paul used to dance and sing at the Piccadilly.
Well, you were right there. What do you mean that Paul used to?
Well,
we used to.
I guess I was there. I just don't remember.
Hey, guys, talking about the Coach Lombardi before we let you go. Talk about Jerry Kramer and bringing out the CD and bringing out Inside the Locker Room.
I think it's great. You know, more power to it. He had more brains than the rest of us. But I just wonder what would have happened if the coach would have caught that. You know, in the locker room that game. I was there. I had retired. But I went back for that game, of course, and I was sitting in the locker room. And it's become a pretty popular disc up here in Wisconsin, I understand. And more power to him. I thought it was a brilliant move. But, if the old man would have caught him with that thing, it would have been hell to pay.
We're going to go ahead and take a quick break, ladies and gentlemen. Max McGee.